students, we have, in the last lecture, we have seen the different constituents of food. The constituents are carbohydrates, proteins, then vitamins, minerals, roughage, water. These are not nutrients, but they require for us. So main constituents are carbohydrates, fats and proteins. So first we'll see what is balanced diet. So balanced diet means the diet which supplies us all the constituents or nutrients, carbohydrates, proteins, then fats, vitamins, all these constituents of the food which the diet gives a proper amount and thus help us to grow properly. Such type of diet is called as balanced diet. In short, whatever the person requires, according to that they have to take carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins and all these things, which gives us the balanced diet, and that is why its body growth is taking properly and it remains healthy. So that we call that balanced diet. The diet which supplies us to all the nutrients in proper amount to grow properly and to keep it healthy, that is called as balanced diet. Now we'll see what is food pyramid. Food pyramid or food triangle, pyramid also called, or it is also called as food triangle. So at the base there is carbohydrates. At the base, carbohydrates are there, leafy vegetable, then sprouted cereals, fruits, these are the base. Then in the second stage, there is milk, then meat. All these things are there in the second group, and in the last group there is fats, means oil, butter, ghee. So this we called as the food triangle or food pyramid. So at the base it is carbohydrates, leafy vegetables and sprouted cereals and fruits. So you have to take in your diet this part which is at the down, that you have to take in the more amount. Then at the middle, milk and meat, that you have to take in the moderate, is whatever necessary that you have to take in the food, that is moderate. And at the top of the triangle, there are fats, oil, butter, ghee is there. So this is not required much. So that things which you are getting from the food, that you have to take in very less amount. So in this way, food triangle is there. It is also called as food pyramid. So most of the things we have to eat, carbohydrates more, leafy vegetables, fruits and cereals, which keeps us very healthy. Because of the milk and meat, they will be required for making our bones strong, but they have to take in moderate, not in more. And at the last or at the top, there is fats, oil, butter is gained. They will be required, but we don't want to take more, otherwise it causes the different diseases. So in such a way, our diet should be there. This is called as food triangle or food pyramid. Now next we see the deficiency means what, or deficiency disease. Vitamins we are required for our proper growth, proper health and for the proper growth. Also they help us to fight against disease. So that is the use of vitamins. And vitamins generally we are getting from the leafy vegetables. From leafy vegetables and from fruits, we are getting these vitamins. So vitamins help us to keep our body strong and it help us to fight against disease. But some of the vitamins, if we are not getting, then we have shortage of that vitamin, then we are suffering from the disease that is called as deficiency disease. So first type is vitamin is A. So vitamin A, which helps us to improve our vision. We can see with our eyes. So to improve our vision or to keep our vision good, this vitamin A we require. But if the person is getting lack, means he is not getting that vitamin A, then he will suffer from the disease called as night blindness. If the person is getting lack of vitamin A, then he will suffer from the disease called as night blindness. So blindness means the person cannot see, and night blindness means the person who is lack of this vitamin A, he cannot see at the night. So this is called as night blindness. This is getting the person because of lack of vitamin A. And vitamin A you are getting from the different fruits and all that. Papaya, then orange, from that you are getting this vitamin A, which is the rich source of this vitamin A. Also, the all the leafy vegetables which you are eating, then you are getting this vitamin A. Then second is vitamin B. Because of this vitamin B, if you are not getting that vitamin B, then you suffer from the muscles problem, cramps in the muscle, or you will get tiredness. So this is happens because of lack of vitamin B, and the disease caused by lack of vitamin E, B is called as beriberi. So this vitamin B, if the person is not getting, then the disease cause is called as beriberi. So vitamin B you can get from whole grains, means without covering that, we have to eat that, fruits and vegetables. Means most of the vitamin we are getting from fruits and vegetables. Now vitamin C, that is the third vitamin which we require. So vitamin C, if you are not getting less, then your gums is not proper. The teeth and gums will be not proper, and you will suffer from the disease called as scurvy. Means if the vitamins you are not getting, then you will suffer from disease scurvy. And to get the cure is to, we are getting the vitamin C, as already you are doing, you are eating the every day in your diet, that lemon. The lemon contains lot of this vitamin C. Amla, then orange, all these fruits from which you are getting the vitamin C. And those who are lack of vitamin C, they will suffer from the disease called as scurvy. And last vitamin which we require, that is vitamin D. So vitamin D, if you are not getting properly, then you will suffer from your bones are not strong. Means for making the bone strong, actually calcium and phosphorus minerals are required, but that is synthesized by this vitamin D, and then the person can get this calcium and phosphorus. So vitamin D is also useful. Their bones, means that bones are becoming weak because of lack of this vitamin D, and that disease is called as rickets. So rickets is the disease which is caused due to the vitamin D. So these are the four vitamins, and because of lack of these vitamins, the person suffer from the disease that is called as deficiency disease. If you are getting these vitamins at night or very late, then if vitamin A is not there, you will suffer from night blindness. Vitamin B you are not getting properly, you will suffer from very late. Vitamin C you are not getting, then you will suffer from the scurvy, the disease. And vitamin D, if you are not getting properly, that we can get from also sunlight. In the early sunlight, the vitamin D is present. So small childs are kept in the early sunlight so that he can get this vitamin D. If vitamin D is not getting, then we are suffering from rickets. So night blindness, beriberi, scurvy and rickets, these are called as deficiency disease. Deficiencies means lack. The person is not getting that vitamin in proper amount. That is why he will suffer from this disease. This is called as deficiency disease. At the same time, we require some minerals, and This is also required for us. Now, the minerals we require, that is, first is calcium and phosphorus. These both minerals are very important because our bones are made up of this calcium and phosphorus. Our teeth are also made up of this calcium and phosphorus. So mainly this calcium and phosphorus we are getting from milk and vegetable. If we have lack of this calcium and phosphorus, then our teeth are not become proper and bones becomes very brittle, means they are not proper. So to make the proper growth of bones, we require this calcium and phosphorus, which we are getting from this milk and vegetable. Then the one more mineral we require, that is iron. The iron we are getting from leafy vegetables. If you are eating vegetables, which is leafy vegetables, especially fenugreek. Fenugreek means in Marathi we call it as methi. So from that methi we are getting this iron. And iron is very important because it forms red blood cells. In our body, blood is there. So in that blood, these red blood cells are present, which is formed by this iron, as well as it supplies the oxygen through the blood to the different cells through this iron medium. So for making the new RBC, means red blood cells in the blood, and also hemoglobin, to form the hemoglobin, which is the part of the blood, this iron is very important. So iron we are getting from mostly leafy vegetables and fenugreek. Then iodine is the one more mineral which we are getting from the salt which we are eating every day. If the food, in the food salt is not there, then it does not become tasty. So we are putting this salt, and salt makes our food tasty. But if the salt is not getting to the person, then he will be the lack of this iodine mineral. So salt contains, which we are eating daily, that salt contains iodine, and if the iodine is not getting proper, this person is suffering from the disease called a goiter. The goiter means one leg becomes swollen. So iodine is also one more important mineral which we require in our everyday life, means for our food. So these are the main minerals which we want to take in our diet, that is calcium, phosphorus, which makes our bone and teeth strong. Iron is also one more important mineral which makes the hemoglobin in our blood. It forms the red blood cells in our blood. It helps to pass the oxygen through the blood to the different cells. And iodine, which is we get from our salt, which we are eating every day. And if the salt we are not getting in proper amount, then we will suffer, means lack of this iodine, and then we suffer from the disease called as goiter. So in this way, vitamin, lack of vitamin and lack of minerals, they will suffer from some diseases, and also they will affect our body growth. Then next we see what is the disease. So disease is the condition in which the proper working of the body is not disturbed. Then we say that it is a disease, means our body is not working properly, then we have some disease like that we see. So if vitamins are less in our body, then we suffer from deficiency disease. But that disease will not transfer to the other person or other boys and girls, because that person only is lack of this. It will not go to the other person and all that. So it will not transfer from one person to other. I mean, suppose one boy is getting less vitamin A, while other boy also is playing with him or sitting with him, then he will not get the lack of vitamin A. So means in short, this vitamin, though to the deficiency of this disease, they will not transfer from one person to other by contact. So such type of disease are called as non-communicable.
these are called as non-communicable disease. Means though being comes in contact with the person who is suffering from any disease, and that will not come to the our body or that will not suffer us. Such type of diseases are called as non-communicable disease. Means though we are in
coming in contact with other, then also we cannot suffer from that disease. Such type of disease are called as non-communicable disease. Nowadays, you are most of the world is suffering from the corona. So corona is not non-communicable, it is communicable. So if we come in the contact with the person who is having the corona disease, then it will come to the you also. So it is safe that we have to keep social distances. So corona is communicable disease, but is vitamin deficiency, they are not communicable disease, they are called as non-communicable disease, means they cannot go from one person to other. So this is called as non-communicable disease. Now the other part is called as communicable disease. Now the disease which transfer from or which spread from one person to other, if disease is spread from one person to other, means if the person is suffering from cold or cough or exceptionally cold, then if the person or boy sitting with us, after 1 or 2 days he will also suffer from cold or sneezing and coughing. So sneezing and coughing are communicable disease, means they can spread from one person to other. So the disease which spread from one to other, that is called as communicable. So this cough, cold, sneezing, it causes the harm to the other, because when we are sneezing, the germs comes out in the air, and that same germs are absorbed by during the breathing by other person, then that germs enter in their body and he will also suffer from cough or cold. So this type of disease which can spread from one person to other, they are called as communicable disease. So that we have to take the proper precaution so that we cannot come in contact with the person who is having such disease. So corona is the such type of disease where it can spread from one person to other, and that is why we have to keep social distances, we have to wear the mask, we don't want to go in the crowd because it can spread from one person to other immediately, and it is because of the virus. So most of the disease which caused by virus, they are communicable, and bacteria also they also spread this the disease. So the disease which spread from one person to other, they are called as communicable disease. Example is corona. Now this is all of you are knowing, this disease is communicable, it can spread from one person to other. Cough, cold, so all these diseases are spread from one person to another, so they are called as communicable disease. So there are two types of disease are there, non-communicable and communicable. The disease which do not spread by contact, they are called as non-communicable, and the disease which spread by contact, they are called as communicable disease. So we can make overcome by using the certain rules and regulation. We can avoid this communicable disease that we see in the next chapter.